To illustrate the idea of a polynomial reduction, we're going to reduce the problem of finding an independent set in a graph to that of finding a vertex cover. In the next lesson, we're going to argue that if p is not equal to np, then independent set is not in p, so vertex cover can't be either. But that's getting ahead of ourselves. First, for the benefit of those not already familiar with these problems, we will state them briefly.
First, we'll consider the independent set problem and see how it is equivalent to the clique problem that we talked about when we introduced the class np. Given a graph, a subset of the vertices is an independent set if there are no edges between the vertices in the set S. For example, these two vertices here do not form an independent set because there's an edge between them. However, these three vertices do form an independent set because there are no edges between them. Clearly, each individual vertex forms an independent set since there isn't another vertex in the set for it to have an edge with. And the more vertices we add, the harder it is to find new ones to add. So finding a maximum independent set is the interesting question. Or, phrased as a decision problem, the question becomes, given a graph G and an integer K, at most the number of vertices, does G have an independent set of size K? Note that this problem is in NP. Given a subset of the vertices, it's easy to count them to make sure that there are indeed K and check that there are no edges between them. This problem is so close to the clique problem that the two are usually considered as one. A set is independent in a graph if and only if it is a clique in the complement graph. By the complement graph, I mean the one where there is no edge if there was an edge between two vertices in the original, and there is an edge if there wasn't one in the original. Not having any edges between a set of vertices in the original graph is the same as having all the edges among the vertices in the complement graph.